everybody, and welcome to Greek TV. I'm Brianna.
And I'm Brian.
And it's our first show of the semester.
That's right. Hey, I'm happy to be back. How
about I'm so happy, and I'm especially happy that we're back at the original day and time of Friday at 2 p.m. That's when it was when we first started the show.
More Saturday mornings.
Yes.
No more Saturday mornings. You can sleep in tomorrow. It's going to feel great.
As fun as that was, I have to say I appreciate the Friday at 2
Absolutely.
Time
Absolutely.
Frame a little bit better. but I'm so pumped for this semester. I hope you're pumped for this semester.
I'm very excited. Very excited. Now,
awesome.
We are bi-weekly
mm-hmm.
as well, so that's another change to the format.
But yeah, we're flip-flopping mm-hmm. with another show called The Spiel, mm-hmm. which will be opposite weeks that we go on at the same time and day. And that's a show about like Jewish life mm-hmm. here at KU. So it's kind of like similar style show, just about a different topic.
Maybe we like could collaborate with them.
Think we're planning on doing that actually, somehow bringing in Greek life and Jewish life together. We'll figure that out and that would be really fun. So it'll be every other week at Fridays at 2, so that will be a lot of fun.
All right.
But school is back in full swing.
That's right.
How have your classes been so far?
They'd be good. Nothing too boring yet, so that's solid. That's solid. I'm still staying awake in class, so how about yourself?
They've been good. I feel like, though, I didn't really get like a syllabus week or chillabus week or whatever. It was just straight into like, okay, you're back.
I kind of feel the same way. We just kind
of
went right into homework, you know, first night. It's like, it's college for you, though.
Yeah, I think it's junior year, sophomore year. It's no more fun and games. It's all
so work. Now you had to come back to school quite a bit earlier before mm-hmm. classes actually started. What was that for?
I did. Okay, so I was back very early. Mm-hmm. I actually came back the end of June, but I started doing work in the beginning of August because I was actually a recruitment counselor this year for fall formal recruitment for Panhellenic. And that was a lot of fun. I had a blast. Actually, Sam mm-hmm. Harms, who is another host of Greek TV who couldn't be here today, she was my partner, which was really fun because we're really good friends and we had a blast. That's our recruitment group actually at bid day. That was the best day ever. It was so much fun. Sam's face begs to differ, but it was fun. and this is us with our group. So what we did was kind of like what a camp counselor would do.
Okay.
We had these group of women from Ellsworth, floor 5 and 6, and we basically just counseled them through the week. We went with them everywhere they went to all the different chapters during recruitment week. this was actually after preference one night. They were so tired, and they were like, we literally could just lay down here and sleep, and we're like, oh, we'll go right ahead. And they all just laid in a line, and we took a picture because we thought it was funny. But, so we went with them through the week and kind of just helped them. Mm-hmm. So recruitment's a really, really stressful process.
Yeah, I was just going to say, I think the guys kind of have it easy.
Yeah.
We don't go through all of that. It doesn't take an entire week to, you know, walk around to every house, and, you know, you're in the hot, and
it's grueling.
Yeah,
it is. Can you kind of explain the fraternity process a little?
So,
because I don't know much about it.
At KU, and every university does it a little bit differently, but at Kansas we do kind of an informal. Now we also have a formal option, and mm-hmm. I know my house, we mainly do most of our recruitment informally, and that takes place throughout the entire year.
Mm-hmm.
So we will have guys up in the fall, you know, we'll hang out with them over winter break, and then usually we'll do a lot of our signing in the spring. So I personally only rushed three different houses, so mm-hmm. I didn't have to worry about going around and trying to make brownie points with every single house on campus, and I didn't have to didn't have to do anything like that. So mm-hmm. I think for the guys, just a lot more relax and laid back, so I'm fortunate that I was able to just
how
go
did
through
you
that.
Like going through, I know you said you only really went to like mm-hmm. three of the chapters, but how did you kind of come to your decision, like what made you choose the one?
So being from out of state, I honestly didn't know a whole lot of people at the University of Kansas, mm-hmm. but I did have a couple contacts here and there in different houses, and then from there I just kind of texted them, hey, you know, how does Rush work?
Because
honestly I didn't really know, but you figured out pretty quickly and you're like, oh, this is pretty chill. You just kind of go up and hang out with the guys. You get to meet the different houses. But basically, I just kind of met different, I got to see different houses because I knew a guy or two in those houses. So, and then you kind of get a pretty good feel for, you know, exactly the personalities of the house overall, and, you know, kind of get a fit because it's like a tryout, you know, you have to make a good impression on them, but you've also got to pick the house that's going to be right for you.
Right, you know? For sure. And it's kind of the same way with sororities. It's just a little more structured, I guess.
Right.
And they kind of give all the chapters a chance, and it is a little different, but in a mm-hmm. way it's kind of the same. And actually we get to hear from a new member of our crew who just went through recruitment. Okay. Her name is Natalie. She's going to kind of share her experience in the next segment.
All right.
So we kind of get to hear like firsthand what all went on behind the scenes. The horror stories, but then the positive sides too.
That's good.
But yeah, so she's going to talk with us pretty soon. So,
all right.
Yeah. But stay tuned, and after the break, we will be back with Natalie and Ashley for a recruitment recap. Welcome back. I'm Ashley Hawking.
Hi, I'm Natalie Sitek.
So I'm a sophomore, so I went through recruitment last year, and then this year I got to kind of be part of the process from behind the scenes.
Yeah, and I was just going to ask her, what was your favorite part of being on the other side?
So my favorite moment was on bid day, and the girls come on buses from the union after like opening their bid cards. Mm-hmm. And my favorite part was when my rush crush came off the bus and I like ran into her arms and gave her a big hug.
Yeah, that is awesome. Bid day was one of my favorite parts as well. And what was your least favorite part of?
I think my least favorite part was we had to be very quiet in the basement, because if there's noise coming from the house, that means that the round kind of starts and we'll get in trouble. Mm-hmm. And so I didn't like having to be quiet for like 30 minutes at a time.
Yeah, that was tough on us as well, because I'm a freshman, so I just went through the recruitment process. And the hardest part, I think, is kind of having to wait in the lines and be quiet and just, you know, sit there. And going to every house, that can be a long, long day. But my favorite part was definitely at the end when we found out which house we were in. And then you just have a big celebration and the whole week is over, so.
Yeah, did you have any favorite moments during the week that kind of helped you decide which house you wanted to be in?
You know, I really like skit day, and when we got to tour the houses, I thought that was the coolest part, because you can actually see if you can like picture yourself in the house and the skits, and you get to like, kind of see a personality of the house and like where you feel like you fit in. So that was probably my favorite day.
Yeah, I definitely like skit day as well. Mm-hmm. It was very funny. Even though we kind of saw the skit like 50 times in a row, we still thought it was funny every time.
Yeah, well, it's funny because you guys know the people too.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, well, after this, we'll have our news segment.
Welcome back. I'm Brian, and I'm here with IFC Public Relations Officer Joe Simmons, and we just have a couple questions for you. We're going to kind of talk about, well, it's been in kind of a lot of talk recently. It's been on the internet. People, mm-hmm. It's kind of a big news subject for this year. The new alcohol ban. Can you tell me a little bit about that?
Right, yeah. In May, the chapter presidents of the Interfraternity Council came together and voted in for a hard alcohol ban. Now, what that means is on chapter premises at the University of Kansas, mm-hmm. there should be no alcohol 13% ABV or above. So that excludes beer, most beers, wine, champagne, but hard alcohol is something that is strictly forbidden at fraternities.
Okay, and you guys decided on this last year, you said?
Yeah, in May, that's when the actual voting happened the last general council meeting. However, the discussion about it started back in November. There was a group of concerned Greek leaders and concerned alumni that came together and kind of recognized that KU had, compared to other more local, other Midwestern universities, kind of had a drinking problem. Mm-hmm. There was just rampant, widespread access to hard alcohol, and for young freshmen coming in that have no experience drinking, it was a very, very dangerous situation. So that being recognized, there was a change that needed to happen.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so can you tell us a little bit about how this will affect University of Kansas and Greek life here as a whole?
Sure. Well, we hope that this change is going to be, and it's going to start out kind of rocky. It's a big thing for a lot of people, mm-hmm. but in a system that has a four-year turnover rate. So in 4 years, we're not going to be here, as sad as that is. You know, there's going to be 1,700 new people in this system. Mm-hmm. So they're probably going to come into a time when something like the presence of hard alcohol isn't even a thing. Yeah. We have likened this whole situation to a keg ban that happened in the 90s. Mm-hmm. That was kind of, you know, the sky is falling, it was terrible. But 4 years later, and today, it's kind of a rare thing.
Yeah.
If it doesn't happen at all.
And other universities have kind of hopped on this same mm-hmm. train, right?
Right. Actually, we're Oklahoma has one. They have their own kind of policy. Mizzou, K-State. So we're kind of now in that mix.
Gotcha. So, but I mean, overall, this is a positive change to the university?
Yeah, I believe so. I think from a PR perspective, that's mm-hmm. my job.
Absolutely.
It looks really good to say that chapter presidents voted this in. It wasn't a top-down approach from alumni or from the university in stating this policy. It was us mm-hmm. that recognized the problem. And that's huge. But it puts a lot of weight in our shoulders
right.
because the way that it's being enforced is through chapter leadership on an individual basis,
right.
which is a lot for a small body of executives elected for every chapter. Mm-hmm. So we're hoping that each leader can recognize their responsibility for all this.
And if I'm not mistaken, back in May when this was voted on mm-hmm. by all the presidents, it was a unanimous decision. What do you think that says about kind of the Greek life here?
I think it says that 23 guys came together
yeah.
that were elected by their chapters and came into a setting that was not something that they ever thought they'd have to be in.
Right.
And they took ownership of the situation, mm-hmm. which is huge.
Yeah, responsible. Mm-hmm. Honestly, it's probably just the right thing to do.
Right, exactly.
All right. Well, hey, thank you very much,
yeah,
Joe, for
no
coming
problem.
In.
Absolutely.
That'll wrap us our interview up with Joe Simmons. Now, we are going to go. We'll be right back with the news. We're going to come back with TJ and Kara.
There's nothing more powerful than an idea whose time has come. An idea for a brotherhood whose bond is found centuries deep. One whose history has faced defeat and then crushed it. Bringing its members together for an experience made from the thread that weaves our dreams. We stand together. We push one another. We enjoy life alongside each other. We're more than just a fraternity. We're the product of Jewish pride and perseverance. Save me.
Welcome back to Greek TV. I'm TJ Blake.
And I'm Kara Khan. Here's your weekly news update. Alpha Phi Sorority at the University of Alabama is under criticism this month for a recruitment video that objectified women. Recruitment videos typically highlight the positive aspects of Greek organizations to interest potential new members. Critics say the video only highlighted the looks of the chapter members rather than their ideals. The video was removed from YouTube after it reached 500,000 views.
Sasa Jajilian, a Kappa Alpha Theta from Columbia University, became the first woman to climb the north face of the Eiger in Switzerland. It took her and her partner 4 days and three nights to climb the 13,020-foot mountain. Sasha is a three-time national champion and a 2011 overall world champion in sport climbing.
Actress Drew Barrymore made a surprise visit at Kappa Kappa Gamma Sorority at the University of Arkansas. Barrymore brought the women makeup samples from her new makeup and eyewear line from Walmart. Barrymore also expressed interest in becoming the sorority house mother.
Well, Delaney Stengel, a Chi Omega Oklahoma University, is suing the sorority after she severed her Achilles tendon when an automatic door shut on her leg. Stengel filed the claim 9 months after the incident actually took place back in November. Stengel claims she is entitled to recover any damages and hopes to be compensated for medical bills and court costs.
KU's Interfraternal Council banned the possession and consumption of hard alcohol on fraternity property. The action addresses the critical issues of alcohol abuse and sexual violence on campus. The ban was voted upon by IFC last May and starts this month. The ban does not include beer and wine. Stay tuned and we'll be back with our first Greek of the Week segment.
Where you go to college makes a statement about you. This place will become a part of you, your identity for life. The University of Kansas, a great place to be you.
Welcome back. So on our social media this week, we gave a shout out to Alpha Gamma Delta, which is a sorority here at KU for our Greek of the Week segment. And so if you tune into our Twitter, it kind of gives some statistics of that chapter. Their philanthropy, their total member count for their house, their symbols, stuff like that. So definitely check that out. We'll be doing it on social media every week. And then every other week when we're on air, we'll do it live. We'll have graphics and all that for that. So we kind of randomly selected each week which ones we're going to shout out. So tune in to see if your chapter is, when your chapter is up. So
follow us at Greek TV on Twitter and Instagram and Facebook.
Yes. So you can see those and see some other updates that we have all throughout the week. We post pretty much every day about stuff. If we're not on air, we'll be tweeting news out and all that. So definitely check that out. But we won't be live next Friday. It will be the spiel. So tune into that. That's next Friday at 2 and see what they're up to. And then we will be back on the 18th with our next live show. So thank you guys so much for watching today. And tune into us next time.